Volunteer search and rescue groups right across our community work tirelessly to provide assistance to those who get into difficulties with terrain or conditions that they're unfamiliar with. It's a hugely important piece of work. It literally saves lives. And today I'm delighted to be able to announce the funding for this year of £100,000. Hopefully this will help them buy new equipment and also be able to access the training and the transport that they need to be able to continue this vital service.
Funding from the Department of Justice is basically essential to the team, particularly this year with COVID. Our own funding exercises have been curtailed severely, so we rely totally on it for personal protective equipment for our members, for the actual rescue equipment, vehicles, fuel, maintenance and so on. So it's absolutely essential. At the minute with the COVID-19 restrictions, when we're going to be working closely with a casualty, we have to wear masks and gloves, we use hand sanitizer and so on. When the team would arrive at a casualty site as such, we would send one member of the party forward as the safety officer. We would then lay our kit out in a kit dump, and some of the members would go forward to treat the casualty and assess further what the injuries are and what more equipment's needed.
The protectionist group actually consists of 9 voluntary groups, and we're here today to see the North West Mountain Rescue carry out a training exercise. And it coincides with the recent funding that we were able to provide by the Department of Justice. Ordinarily, all of the groups do excellent fundraising throughout the year, but of course this has been significantly reduced because of the recent COVID-19 lockdown.
Our members are all 100% voluntary. They do purchase a lot of their own personal gear themselves out of their own pocket, and without the funding from the DOJ and the support of the general public, we just simply couldn't do what we do.